Louise, I've been reading a lot about you. It says here that she claims she had journalists interview her just because they fancied her. Is that right?
No, that's not true. I never said that.
Okay, well, if you never said that, I don't care if there was any truth in it. I don't want you to think that's the case this evening.
Okay.
I want you to know it's the case this evening.
I know it's the
All right? Something else I've got to check out. You claim that you don't crave to be loved, you crave privacy, right?
Yeah, I crave privacy.
Would you like a screen?
Yeah, I'd like to put a screen just here, right now.
We haven't got a screen, it's just a joke. That's all it was. Just a little joke for you, Louise. Thanks for coming on the show.
Thanks.
Thanks for coming. You've been on with your band before, but you've never sat at the desk.
No.
We want you to sit at the desk. Now, this is...
very nice.
Do you like it? Mm. It's the one we used in rehearsal months and months ago, and we thought, well, what the heck, it's the original desk, why kick it out? It's not fair. Get some big posh desk, and we don't want that. This is in fact, you can have this desk if you ever want it.
I'd love this desk.
This is the first big interview you've ever done on TV, right? I don't want you to be nervous, okay? And I don't want you to pause.
Alright.
And I want you to be very funny.
Okay.
Alright? If at any moment you do pause, alright, look nervous, or not be funny, we will show a photograph of you as a baby, alright? And we have 10 photographs of Louise as a baby. Here's one. There you are. We have 9 others, so no pauses, all right?
All right.
Okay, no pauses whatsoever. Let's go.
Right.
So first of all, sleeper.
Yeah.
Right, sleeper could mean earring.
Mm-hmm.
It could mean the thing under the big piece of wood underneath the rail track.
Yeah.
It could mean sleeping, a sleeper.
It means a spy, all sorts of
Which
things.
Sleeper are you?
We're Woody Allen's sleeper, that's what we are.
Is that what you're named after?
Yeah.
Woody Allen's band?
Woody Allen's film. He
didn't have a band. No, he didn't have a band, did he? I'm sorry, I'm off. Show a baby, show
So do we get to show a picture of you as a baby now?
Show a baby, I was going to say, show a baby photo of me, but we haven't got any, I'm sorry. So let's show another one of you instead. Let's have another one of you. Just okay. Okay, from now on, whenever... They are beautiful, aren't they? Whenever I make a mistake, we also show a picture of you as a baby. Which I know is a bit unfair, but there you are.
Really unfair.
It is a bit unfair. Did Sleeper find you, did the band find you, or did you find the band?
Well, I formed it at college in Manchester with John, and we were together, and then we came down to London, we advertised for 2 more people.
When you say you're together, you were together.
Yes, we were.
You were together.
Yeah.
Okay, John is the
guitarist?
Okay. But you're not together with John anymore.
No.
Not personally, but professionally you are. Yeah?
Yes.
You are now with...
Andy.
Who is?
The drummer.
That's fantastic, isn't it?
Yeah, I'm working my way through the whole band.
I know, well, this is what I was going to ask you, because the thing is, tonight you've employed 2 more male members of the band, so there are 5 boys, because you're working through so fast now.
Yeah, we're going to get a string section, you know, brass, everything.
You're just having the time of your life,
yeah,
aren't you?
Yeah, totally.
I heard you on the radio a couple of weeks ago, on the day you were going to start your tour, on the Sunday, I think it was, and you said that you're really disappointed at the lack of male groupies at the end of gigs. The boys got loads of girls.
They get loads of girls. They all come up together in gangs. Mm. They come straight up and they say, do you want to straight out?
Oh, do they?
Yeah.
and nothing for you?
No, the guys come up and they bring you sort of little poems or sort of flowers, and they're really shy and they're really sort of, you know, a bit scared.
Scared of you?
So it's very different.
I've got no idea how they feel at all. Louise has been around all day here. Now, what I really want to know is, as far as... your reputation is concerned, you're renowned for being very opinionated.
Mm.
Yeah? What particular opinions do you have? What are your staunchest opinions?
I don't know. People, they're always saying kind of stuff about what I say and I'm controversial, but I've never said anything controversial the whole time. It's just like...
But you will take it out of context.
Yeah, it's just sort of bedwetting journalists, you know, that sit there and you know, read it, get shocked, and they have to see Nursey for 6 months afterwards.
You know why that is? Because they're scared of you, Lulu. That's what it's all about. They're all scared of you, aren't they?
Excellent.
Have you always wanted to be famous?
Oh yeah, everyone wants to be famous.
You think so?
Yeah.
See, there's another sweeping. See, that's you know, a sweeping statement, girl, which is good. It's either black or white, because you were in Jackie once, weren't you? You were. You were in this edition of Jackie. Look at this. Now. So anyways, I thought that was you on the front, but it's not you on the front, is it?
No.
Okay, I'm still in, by the way. I am still definitely in. Later I'll be out, but I'm still in for the moment. You were inside, though, in a photo love story, weren't you?
Yeah, I was young, I needed the money.
Hey, no, there's nothing wrong with it. But we have got it. Do you mind if we show it? Do you want to see it?
Yeah!
Oh, they've shown it without your permission. I was going to ask your permission. There you are, and there's another photograph as well. Here we go. Another photograph? We got another one? Oh, was there two there? Did we see both of them?
No.
Just the one. We have. There's the other one. All right. Aww. I think you look great in those. Can I ask you about the fact that you were supposed to be on last week's show?
Yeah, we were.
Yeah? Right. You were supposed to be on last week's show, but in fact, we wouldn't have had time to interview you, and I really wanted to talk to you at the desk, because I think you're a complete star, right? But you're a bit miffed. Not, you weren't angry, but you're a bit miffed at missing last week's show for a very special reason, weren't you?
Yes, because I wanted to meet George Best, the fifth Beatle.
The fifth Beatle?
And the only one still living that's any good as well.
Oh, yes! You're full of these, aren't you? Well, look, I may pass out, right? This may even kill me, but I reckon I've got a dream thing going on. I can dream things for you. I can dream you a meeting with George Best if you want me to try.
Excellent, yeah.
Okay, but you're going to have to look after me if I suffer because of it. All right? Okay, hang on a sec. Just give me a moment, please. Please, best of order.
Hello, I'm George Best.
Hi, I'm Louise from Sweden.
Hi, great meeting.
You too. Wow, this is like a total dream for me.
Well, actually, it's one of Chris's dreams, but I know what you mean.
Well, listen, I hope we get to meet in real life someday.
I'm sure we will. Bye.
Bye.
Amazing, it worked.
That was amazing.
Don't ask me to do anything else for the moment. This is a true story, what I'm going to tell you now. This is a true story. We've got to move on, but this is a true story, okay?
Okay.
Just before the show started, we finished dress rehearsals an hour earlier because you were so well behaved. And we were allowing for an extra half hour of bad behaviour, right? Mm. We went to the newsagents and we bought some lottery tickets, right? And what happened was, if you look at this lottery ticket here, I rubbed off four of my spaces and I've got 250,000. Right? I don't know if you can see this. And I've got two left to go. And you can either rub this off with me or you can buy it off me for a tenner and rub the other one. What do you want to do?
I think I should rub it off now.
Wait, have you got a tenner?
I've got a tenner.
Cool! All right, then. Yeah. All right, then. There you are. Okay, if you just use the end of my pen.
Okay.
Okay. No, not to colour it in, you've got to rub it off. But, okay, the first one is a do it slowly. It's slower. Oh. It's 1,000, right? Okay. We've got one more for 50 grand. Come on, Lou. I only got a tenner, I've got my tenner. 50 grand, this is genuine. Come on.
Definitely gonna do it.
Come on. Oh, it's 250. Oh, never mind. That's the way it goes.
Ripped off by Chris Evans. Oh,
are you going to stick around for us?
Yeah, I'm going to stick around.
Okay,
definitely.
Look what I've got, everybody. Look what I've got. I've got one of those silly substitute boards. Okay, and what I can say is that was part one of TFI Friday. Coming up, we got part two. Yay! Still to come, Louise is going to sing a song for us, aren't you?
Yeah.
Okay, new singer with your band. Nigel Kennedy plays more football results, long drinks and small talk with George Best, and we become the only show to float a 100-foot trophy down the Thames. That's all from part one. Back in part two. Yeah! Earlier we heard her chat, now let's hear her sing. It's Louise Wener and Sleeper with their brand new song. It's out on July the 1st. It's called Nice Guy Eddie.
Oh,
really